Now, since it is April 1, I wanted to do something that would hopefully last for, the succeeding years if this channel lasts that long. And every April Fool's Day, I wanted to review a comedy that made an effect on me, really made me laugh. At first, I wanted to review 21 Jump Street, but then 22 Jump Street is coming out anyway later this year, and I'm probably gonna see it. So, just to review something else, I thought of the first movie that really, really made me laugh out loud as a kid, and that would be this one. So, let's get into it. The Emperor's New Groove is directed by Mark Dindal, written by David Reynolds, and features voices of David Spade, John Goodman, Patrick Warburton, Eartha Kitt. Now, The Emperor's New Groove takes place in the Incan Empire, and we have this emperor named Cusco, who's 17 years old, and he's like this big spoiled brat. He just takes care of his kingdom, his empire, like it's nothing. He just thinks about himself all the time, and he gets some people mad. There's John Goodman's character, Pacha, who, he's going to destroy their town just to make way for his vacation house. And then you have Eartha Kitt, who plays Yzma, who is like his advisor, farmer advisor slash mad scientist, who is plotting to kill him with Patrick Warburton's character, Kronk. However, thanks to Kronk's stupidity, Cusco ends up turning into a llama instead, and he ends up with Pacha, and they're kind of, on the run, trying to figure out how to bring Cusco back to his human self while Pacha's trying to save his town from being demolished. Now, it's interesting, when you do research on The Emperor's New Groove, you discover that this movie had lots of troubled production going into it. As in, this movie almost didn't get made. It started out as this thing called Kingdom of the Sun, I think, and it was supposed to be this big epic thing like The Lion King that would actually be about the Incan Empire and stuff. In fact, they even brought in Sting from the Police to write songs for it. But lots of bad things happened. This is the part in Disney film history where they kind of hit their slump. Because, they had a whole string of movies from Little Mermaid up to Tarzan that were considered classics now, but then right after that, this came out in 2000, and this kind of stuff just wasn't being well received. However, this movie did get made, and I'm glad that it did, because in my opinion, it is the first and only true Disney comedy. It's the only movie I can really say this is a comedy, nothing else. Because all other Disney movies, they do have that ability to be comedy and drama, lots of different things, but Emperor's New Groove really is just focused on being a comedy. And I also think it is severely underrated. Whenever people recall favorite Disney movies and stuff, they go for the touching ones, and yeah, I get why, but let's not forget movies like this that are so unique, especially in the Disney canon, and Emperor's New Groove is just so enjoyable to watch. Part of the reason why it's funny is because the animators here have lots of fun with speed and just, transformations and stuff, because a big part of this movie is, potions and whatever and transforming from animal to animal. And, not just that, but just there's just so much stuff happening all the time that just the speed everything goes through, it just ends up being funny because, it's just hit after hit. But surprisingly, there's also a balance between the wackiness and the more traditional proper character models. Like Pacha and Kronk look like normal people, as far as animation goes, and Pacha's family and all that. And then on the other side, you have Yzma, who's like this walking corpse, and you have Cusco as a llama. And again, with the lightning fast pacing, this movie is like below an hour, 20 minutes. It is so short, but it doesn't really feel like it's too short, honestly, because it just the way it moves is just so satisfying. In fact, this movie almost feels like a sketch comedy to me. It really does, because it doesn't really feel like necessarily it's staying so strict to this plot. They're just having fun as they go on. What I like so much also is that, with a story like this, you might expect some slow moments and things, but sometimes they do it just kind of run past those inevitable slow moments by acknowledging that they're in the movie. There's tons of meta references in this movie, and I like how they just do it, and they just never, they don't really care about it. It's there. And in terms of plot, this movie has nothing to do with The Emperor's New Clothes, which is a short story by Hans Christian Andersen, I think. And so yeah, don't look at that. But surprisingly, this really is like a character-driven kind of plot, and the characters here are surprisingly well drawn out for a movie so short. Just little things like Kronk being able to communicate with squirrels and having the whole devil angel thing on his shoulders. That's just interesting to watch, and everyone has their own little quirks like that. And in terms of dialogue, in my opinion, this whole movie is quotable. Like, if you go to the IMDb page under quotes, there should be the entire script there, because every single line here is just really, really funny, and it's just a lot of it feels very improvised, and it's just rapid fire. Now, one of the best things, though, about The Emperor's New Groove is the voice acting. So the voice acting is surprisingly really, really well done because everyone just commits to their characters. David Spade as Kuzco, he's like 30-something here. He was 30-something at the time making this, but he really does sound like this spoiled 17-year-old. But again, what I like with his character is that he has real dramatic moments also. He can switch between those two pretty easily. John Goodman is always good in whatever he does, and him as Pacha, like, he really, really fits the character. And he's a good, very good counterbalance to Cusco without him feeling like a killjoy. Like, it really does feel like he does feel like a moral center, and they do balance each other out very well. But Eartha Kitt and Patrick Warburton, like, most people agree that they really do steal the show. They are so hilarious in this movie because, again, they balance each other perfectly because Eartha Kitt is very, and she's very stuck up and she's very evil, like, feeling evil and stuff. And Patrick Warburton is just this big lovable oaf, and just their interplay is really, really well done, and they just have so much fun. Like, they bring so much to their characters. And in terms of direction from Mark Dindal, this almost feels like Phil Lord and Chris Miller, the directors of 21 Jump Street and the Lego Movie. It almost feels like this is a movie they would have made for, like, kids and stuff. This really does feel like that kind of humor, you know, really fast, irreverent, you know, don't care about narrative structure kind of humor. And I know for some movies and some comedies it doesn't work to have, you know, to disregard certain things, but here the utter disregard for logic just works so well because, you know, it's clear from like the first 10 minutes of this movie that this movie is not trying to be a traditional Disney movie. That's what I like so much about it, that it is so dedicated to not being a typical Disney movie. Ultimately, though, this movie, in my opinion, doesn't really reach a level of greatness like other movies do. Because, you know, while it is really funny, while it is a very true comedy, it ultimately is very light. And the transition from what it was supposed to be as like this Incan epic thing to a smaller character-driven comedy like The Emperor's New Groove, like, they really did lose the whole Incan flavor. This doesn't necessarily feel like a kind of movie that takes place in the Incan Empire, and I actually really would have liked to see that just to kind of build the world a bit more. And yes, they could have used a bit more character development, they could have used a bit more dramatic moments, which is always good to have. But I know some people might argue that, you know, it's better this way for it just to be this pure comedy that is like absolutely no regard for drama at all. However, you know, in the end, Emperor's New Groove is still a really good movie in my opinion. For me, these are the kind of movies we really shouldn't forget because they are close to being forgotten. You know, in 50 years and stuff, when people look back at Disney movies, they are obviously going to treasure the better ones more, you know, Lion King and stuff like that. But, you know, movies like The Emperor's New Groove and Treasure Planet and stuff like that, they're not bad movies, and they have very unique things to offer, and especially Emperor's New Groove, which is just really, really laugh out loud funny sometimes. And in my opinion, Disney does need to make more stuff like this because, you know, they're kind of typecast as the animators who do like family movies and stuff and, you know, really touching things, but they have capacity to do really unique, different movies, like in a more niche area, like these comedies and stuff, and I'd like to see them do more of that, do more, you know, daring things. Alright, so that is my review of The Emperor's New Groove. Have you guys seen it? What do you think of it? Tell me what you thought, whether you hated it or loved it. Whatever you think, whether you agree with me or not, please leave me a comment. Let's have a conversation.